Good morning, everyone, and welcome to worship. I'm so glad that you are here with us today. Whether you are here in person with us or you are joining us online, we are glad that you are here worshiping with us. Several announcements for us this morning, and as always, if you miss them here, they're in the good news tomorrow with Sarah's email. The month of October Women's Fellowship is collecting canned meat, jam, and 1 pound spaghetti pasta noodles for their pantry, for Good Samaritan's food pantry, rather. And you can put those in the cart. We still have 3 more Sundays left in October because this is a month with 5 Sundays in it. So we'll be collecting that for the rest of the month. And next week is Jingle Jars already. It doesn't seem possible that next week is the third week, the third Sunday of the month, but next week will be Jingle Jars, so just make sure you have your loose change with you next week. And then starting on Tuesday, October 25th at 6 p.m. at Chippewa, we're going to be doing a book study for 4 weeks, and we will be reading the book, The Simple Faith of Mr. Rogers, Spiritual Insights from the World's Most Beloved Neighbor. We'll be looking at this book and just reading about being a beloved neighbor, and this is a really good introduction to the Vacation Bible School that we'll be having in July. And it will be the beloved neighborhood that we will go and spend a week with, the beloved neighborhood of Mr. Rogers for a week. So thought this book would be appropriate for us to get in the mindset of Mr. Rogers' world for the next year, because who wouldn't want to live in that land of make-believe and being kind to our neighbors and everything. So we will spend our time with this. You can find it on Amazon. The link will be in the good news tomorrow. If you'd like to be a part of this, if you'll either let myself or Sarah know, just so I know who to look for on that first Tuesday, we'd love to have you. And there will be fellowship after church, I believe, right? Mm-hmm. Yes, wonderful. Nita is hosting us for fellowship after church, so make sure you stop in the fellowship room afterwards. And then I think everyone saw the email that Sarah sent out Thursday afternoon. She has to leave at noon tomorrow because her son Jason is having some surgery done. So the office will be open nine to noon tomorrow. So if you need something from her, be there before then, before she has to go and be with her son. Now we will turn to Ruth for our call to worship.
Good morning, one and all. Good morning. A call to worship. Please follow me. Sing God's praises.
Make joyful noise to the Lord.
We have walked through fire and water with heavy burdens on our backs.
But God has led us into a spacious place to plant gardens of faith.
Rejoice in the Lord.
Build houses of joy and shout glory to our God.
Let us worship in gratitude and praise. Our opening prayer, please follow along. Master Gardener, you revive us when our bodies grow weak and when our spirits faint within us. Though we may be bound by our worries, your word is not chained. Help us build houses of joy and plant gardens of faith. As we pray for the welfare of our communities, help us bloom where we are planted, that your harvest of hope and love may be bountiful. In gratitude for your blessings, we pray. that is my gospel, for which I suffer hardship, even to the point of being chained like a criminal. But the word of God is not chained. Therefore, I endure everything for the sake of the elect, so that they may also obtain the salvation that is in Christ Jesus with eternal glory. The saying is sure. If we have died with him, we will also live with him. If we endure, we will also reign with him. If we deny him, he will also deny us. If we are faithless, he remains faithful. He cannot deny himself. Remind them of this and warn them before the Lord that they are to avoid wrangling over words, which does no good but only ruins those who are listening. Do your best to present yourself to God as one approved by him, a worker who has no need to be ashamed, rightly explaining the word of truth. This is the word of the Lord. Amen.
Now I would like to invite any of the children that would like to come forward to hear from Miss Nancy.
Took eight names.
Adriana.
Yes. Well, I have not really a story, but just a lesson today. The Bible says if you help other people, it's just the same as helping Jesus or God. Now, there was hundreds of years ago, there was this man whose name was St. Martin. And one day he gave his cape. He had a cape. It was cold. This was in France, I think, somewhere in Europe. Anyhow, take the cover off that and see what's underneath there. Oh, what's there? Lift those things out.
Warm gloves.
Warm gloves?
And
more gloves. What else is in there? You want to take something out? A hat? That comes down over your ears. That keeps you toasty.
And then,
oh, a nice scarf to put it. You could even put it over your head if you wanted to. So these are all kinds of things that help us to stay warm. Well, let me tell you about, first of all, lots of churches do things like they gather mittens or hats or things like that. And we do that sometimes. We have a giving tree, and at Christmas time we collect mittens and things and give them to people. But our church also does something different. You see this sign here? It says Matthew 25. Matthew 25 is the place in the Bible where God tells us that if we help other people, it's just like helping him. Let me tell you about Matthew 25 in where we live. See this shirt? Yesterday was this Matthew 25 project. We give out free food. Do you know how much free food we gave yesterday?
Why?
13,000 pounds. How many families?
700
families. They drive up, this great huge semi comes from the Akron Canton Food Bank, and they unload huge pallets with thousands of ears of corn and pounds of potatoes and grapes and all kinds of things.
But how could they get around the world to give everybody the food that they need?
You can't. We can just help those people that live by us.
Well, how will people get cold inside?
If they're cold, they should come inside. Good idea.
Yes.
But in lieu of coming inside. So that's one thing. People from our church participate in this. We put this sign out front, and it's the second Saturday of each month from 10 o'clock to 1 o'clock. People come in their cars, and
they drive
through, and there's like a spot here. you pick up potatoes, and the next spot you pick up corn, and the next spot you get green peppers. It's really nice, and they just drive on through and drive out the other side. But anyhow, I want to tell you the story about St. Martin. A long, long time ago, a soldier named Martin was approaching a gate in a city in France. Underneath the archway, he saw a man. The man was huddled against the wall. He was cold and he was shivering. He was poor and he didn't have many clothes on. So St. Martin took off his own warm cape, tore it in half, and he covered up the man with half the cape. That night, Martin had a dream. In it, Jesus was wearing the cape. And he said, Jesus said, Martin, you did this to me because you did it to one of my children. So this inspired him to not be a soldier anymore, but he spent the rest of his life caring for poor and for others in need. And after he died, he became a saint. And in November, there's a special holiday. I didn't even know this. That's called St. Martin's Day, and it's a special day when we think about him and remember how he spent his whole life helping people. And if you help people, you help God.
Well, was he actually a real person?
Oh, yes, he was. But it was a long, long time, hundreds of years ago. He was really a real person, yes. If you have a certain kind of calendar, I bet if you looked on it, on November 11th, you might see down at the bottom, you know where it tells of what the special days, St. Martin's Day. Could we say a little prayer? God, thank you for all that we have, and help us to be ready and eager to share what we have with people who don't have as much as we do. We know if we do this, it makes you very happy. Amen. Okay, thanks for coming up. You want to put those clothes back in here? Thanks very much.
That was wonderful, Nancy. I still don't know how you get down enough.
Getting down isn't so bad. Getting up is another story.
I need help. God bless you. All right, today's gospel lesson comes from Luke chapter 17, verses 11 through 19. Please hear the word of the Lord. On the way to Jerusalem, Jesus was going through the region between Samaria and Galilee. As he entered a village, 10 men with skin disease approached him. Keeping their distance, they called out, saying, Jesus, Master, have mercy on us. When he saw them, he said to them, go and show yourselves to the priests. And as they went, they were made clean. Then one of them, when he saw that he was healed, turned back, praising God with a loud voice. He prostrated himself at Jesus' feet and thanked him. And he was a Samaritan. Then Jesus asked, were not 10 made clean? So where are the other 9? Did none of them return to give glory to God except this foreigner? Then he said to him, get up and go on your way. Your faith has made you well. This is the word of the Lord. Praise be to God. Our hymn is Great is Thy Faithfulness, found on page 140. And if you would please stand.
Thank you.
may be seated. Let us pray. God, let us be able to see and hear each other, to know that our interactions with each other are ways that we can show our gratitude for all that you have provided for us. And may the words of my mouth and the meditations of my heart fall on all who need to hear them this day. Amen. They start lining up early in the morning. Some come alone. Some come with others in their car. But they are lined up, waiting. 700 families waiting to be seen. 77 new families waiting to be heard. On the second Saturday of the month, the parking lot at the elementary school is full of cars and people there to help distribute and receive food from Matthew 25 Outreach Center. Around 6:37 in the morning, a semi pulls in with 13,000 pounds of food on. The food gets sorted and prepped for those that are anxiously waiting in their cars. As those in the cars sit and wait, they are checked in and visited with. They hope to be seen as more than someone coming to get help for their family. They hope that they can share some of who they are, that someone will listen to their stories. The food is passed out. Connections are made, fellowship is had, prayers are said, and we that work hope that we did just a little bit of good in our community that day. Those interactions, the chance to share some of God's love to all that we serve in the morning, is all done that single morning. And we can know that in those small moments that we have helped, we have seen and we have heard, we have had face-to-face interactions with those that we are serving, it makes those things more personal. It gives us a chance to share the love of God, the hospitality of Jesus, and to have the Holy Spirit work among us during that time. That face-to-face experience with Jesus, where they are seen, heard, received, and sent on their way. They obtain a kind of transformative and complete healing that seemed almost impossible before. When first looking at our gospel lesson from today, you might not see how it relates to our mission work with the Matthew 25 Outreach Center. But if you look at what is really happening between those men and Jesus, we can see that our passage and our work that we do go hand in hand together. Those 10 men that came to Jesus were just looking to be seen and heard. They were men that were ignored, thought of as less than, were outcasts in their villages. And they met with Jesus in a village on the outskirts of town, on the borderlands between Samaria and Galilee. We don't know where these men are from. Just they are not part of any specific place. They wandered together as they were looking for help. As they were looking for someone to just simply pay attention to them. Our people that come to us on the second Saturday of the month come to us from all over. Some in Medina County, some from Wayne County. And they come to an elementary school that serves as a place of safety for them. Just as those 10 lepers came to a place with no name to find safety with Jesus. Those 10 lepers that were healed by Jesus walked into a place that was holy, into a place that could be seen as a thin place, as one that blends the material and the spiritual world. And standing on that blacktop, walking between cars with people in them, I know I can say that I am walking on holy ground. All of us there working know that the ground that we are working on and walking on is indeed holy. That something truly special happens as we gather early in the morning to help heal, to help feed those that come to us in just a small, simple way. The people that come to the distribution remind me of the man that turned to Jesus and fell to his feet and praised God and thanked Jesus for healing him. Those that come for help are often filled with overwhelming gratitude that we are there to even help them, that this is even something that we're able to provide. And leaving the cars after checking them in or being ushered through the line or having food placed in their cars, you hear the chorus of thank yous. We are so glad that you are here. This is really going to help this month. In their own way, they are falling to their knees and praising God for the food that we're able to help provide. That one leper, the man that was healed, he stays behind to thank Jesus, to make sure that Jesus knows just how much his health means to him. Both our gospel lesson and our work with Matthew 25 shows us how to show our faith, how we are to carry it with us each day, how if we carry our faith with us, those around us will know that we are people of God. And when we carry it with us, we can be people who live in constant gratitude for all that we have received from our Creator. To have faith is to live it, and to live it is to give thanks. It is living a life of gratitude that constitutes living a life of faith. They go hand in hand. This is the grateful sort of faith that made that man, that made those that come to the elementary school truly and deeply well. Jesus saw each man that came to him for help. He saw them as who they were. He looked them in their eyes and told them what they needed, and they knew what they needed. And while those nine left to do what Jesus told them to do, that one stayed and was told that it was his faith that made him well. He got to have that moment with Jesus where he was seen more, where he was cared for. And those that come through the car line, they want to be seen. They want to be heard. They want to be seen as more than those that are just coming for help. In the two times that I've had the privilege of going up and down the car lines to talk to people, to check them in, to see how they're doing, those that have made eye contact with me, that then share just a little bit of their stories, a little bit about themselves, they see that there is human connection there, that there is relationship building that is happening in those few moments, that it is more than simply putting food in their trunk. It is that human interaction. It is an important part of our gospel passage from Luke. It is an important part of what we do on the second Saturday of the month. It's an important part of our faith. It's why we gather together on Sundays and however we gather. It's why we share how we got here, how our faith got us here. That human interaction makes the whole difference in what Jesus did and what we do. Think of a time when someone saw you, really saw you, held eye contact with you, was interested in what you had to say, cared about what you were saying, saw the worth in your words. Maybe they placed a hand on your arm. Maybe just them sitting there with you made a load of difference. How did that interaction make you feel? How did you feel seen and heard in that moment? Hold on to that feeling. Remember that feeling. That is the interaction that we get to have at the produce distribution. The gratitude that we feel that those that come feel. The gratitude that that man felt as he was laying at Jesus' feet. It's a gratitude that we should carry with us throughout our lives. That feeling of sharing our faith, of sharing the gifts that we have received. It is a feeling that we can and should carry with us every day. So that when we get to hear those departing words that Jesus said to that man, we can know that our faith will help us along on this journey that we call life, and know that they are true, even on the hardest days. Go on your way. Your faith has made you well. Let it be our blessing for our church, for ourselves, as we go on our way, that we can rejoice and give thanks, for in giving thanks in all things, we will find that our God indeed is in all things. I will have to say, Nancy and I did not plan the children's moment or my sermon, so it's always nice when things happen like that. Truly a God moment, I think. Now, let us share our joys and concerns with our community.
Pastor?
Yes, Nancy?
Well, I have joys and concerns. My joy is I've been a Cleveland Indians / Guardians fan since 1948. And I'm very happy today.
Yes.
I have a couple of concerns. Evelyn Hanum called, and her vertigo is back. So that means no driving, and she's limited in what she can do. And I talked with Joanne Turner. Tom was in the hospital just for 2 or 3 days earlier this week. They're having trouble regulating the blood thinners that he's taking. So he was having some internal bleeding. He's also got some thyroid problems that they're trying to work out. He's home now, but Tom and Joe and Evie.
Thank you, Nancy. Anyone else? Anita. I see your hand, Pat. I was like, I saw something in that back corner, and I wanted.
Prayers for Jamie Carpenter. His sister passed away this week. She was only 47, and named Nikki.
Joe. You said head pain? Okay, I wanted to make sure I heard you correctly. Ruth.
Well, I'll let
this is her second visit to adjust hearing and stuff. And she heard a little bit more, but it's still tinny and robotic. She cannot clarify the words, she can't make out. But there was a slight improvement. The doctor was totally impressed with this, because she's one of the few that have had this kind of tumor, and they're not quite sure if everything's going to work that they want to do for her. But it right now it is working. It's been 9 months, and I just admire her, so the strength that she has at the age of 39, and three little ones, and my son, that's the fourth one. But anyways, again, I thank you for the prayers, and just have faith. My prayers are with Dan. I just can't imagine.
Anyone else? Okay, so let us go to God and God, another Sunday, another chance to be filled with the gratitude that we have and being able to worship you and to be your children. God, help us to carry that with us as we leave this place. Help it to not be just a Sunday feeling. Let it be a feeling that we feel filled throughout the week. One that we can share with our neighbors and our friends and those that we meet in the store. And God, we lift up these joys and these concerns that have been named here. For those that are still dealing with Hurricane Ian and all that comes with that. Help them to find the joy in the moments of finding a piano on the street and playing it for their friends. God, we also lift up all those that are held close to our hearts, those that only you know, and those prayers that only you hear. God, hear our prayer as we say the words that your son taught us, the words that help us be filled with gratitude for our faith that we have, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not to temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. As always, we appreciate your continued support of the ministry of the church as we fulfill our mission to love God, love people, and serve the world. Your gifts help us to continue to be a hopeful presence in our community. And my offering is the symbol of all of our offerings back there. And will you please stand as you are able and join in singing the doxology.
Receive our very lives, that we may serve you in the ministry of your church.
closing song for today is Lord, I Lift Your Name on High. Follow along.
Benediction. As you go forth this day, build houses of love and plant gardens of faith.
We will sow seeds of faith and hope and bloom where we are planted.
Care for your neighbors and bear the fruits of kindness and compassion.
We will grow in love.